So today we're going to talk about the number one thing that we're asked about at RV parks.
People come up to us all the time asking, oh, the air skirts, I haven't seen those before. Do you like them? And honestly, we've had really mixed reviews that we've given people because there's been a lot of highs and lows in our experience with the air skirts.
Yeah, we wanted to go with air skirts because of the simplicity.
Yes. When we were looking it up, we're like, air skirts. Oh, this sounds so awesome. It only takes a half hour to install, and then we don't have to touch them again.
Yeah, and you don't have to do any sort of manual labor in order to get your RV prepped. I mean, the benefits of them on paper outweighed all of the competition.
Oh, they seem like the perfect solution. And I'm not saying they're not, but they've had a ton of challenges. We've had them for almost 3 months now, and today's the first day where we think we may not have to touch them.
Yeah, so should we kind of talk about our, I guess, overall experience, the pros, why we chose air skirts, the cons, and we'll kind of talk about some of the competition and the other options as well.
Yeah, I was kind of thinking about starting from the very beginning. So when we were initially looking to buy these, like you said, the competitors, they don't stand a chance against air skirts. We were really close to getting the custom vinyl. Very similar price point, and, you know, the downside of the custom vinyl was that we were going to have to modify our RV, and we decided we didn't want to do that.
Yeah, when we initially started full-time RVing, you know, we were going into this adventure in the winter. Mm-hmm. So we did an enormous amount of research leading up to this, I guess, moment of us going into the winter RVing. And so, yeah, that was on the table with that. But we already knew that we may at some point want to upgrade, at the time, our travel trailer to a larger rig. Turns out that was a lot faster than we anticipated. However, that was a big concern with us. If you go with any of the other options, custom vinyl, do-it-yourself vinyl, styrofoam, which I guess you get rid of that every year, but any of those options, that's staying with your RV.
Right. It's not transferable. Mm-hmm. And we are the kind of people who like to make changes. And, you know, we purchased a brand new travel trailer. So that was important to us that we're not going to modify it because we had heard and read about it devaluing it if we were to modify it. And
yeah,
I found that to be true. So we didn't want to put our holes in it. So we're like, okay, they have the adhesive option. Let's use the adhesives for the vinyl. And we would have to modify our route a little bit because it was supposed to be warm temperatures to install it. So we decided that we would, you know, stop in a warmer climate before going to our final chilly destination, and we would install the adhesives. Mm-hmm. And then we read about how they blow away during windstorms and sometimes with the cold weather that they just fall off. And now that we've lived in our RV for almost 3 months, we've seen that to be true in the windstorms. After it's over, you see people out there with their vinyl skirting going and like reaffixing everything. And we didn't want to deal with that.
Yeah. So once we kind of ruled out the vinyl option, there really was only one other option. I feel like for us, styrofoam, like a do-it-yourself styrofoam kit, was kind of always off the table. And that's mainly due to the amount of time that we were going to be spending at RV parks. I think now that we've done this experience, I actually see the appeal of styrofoam and I actually support it for certain scenarios. And mainly because you're not drilling into your RV, and if you do it properly and take the time with it, it actually can probably be the most insulating. The problem with styrofoam is that it is a custom job, and you are probably spending at least 2 days, from everybody we've talked to that's done it, at least a couple days installing it, taping it, cutting it, all of these things. And with all that, you have to be sure that it's secure because a windstorm could easily take it away. So, you know, the if you're there, if you're in an RV park for a long period of time throughout the entire course of winter, 4 months, maybe 6 months, and you're going to save a lot of money if you do the styrofoam route. So it's probably worth it.
Right. And for us, we plan on staying here for 2 months. And, you know, next year we plan on only staying in one place in the winter for a month and mm-hmm. moving to another one. Styrofoam is definitely off the table in that instance.
It is.
And then comes back to, do I get vinyl or do I get the air skirts?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we have already invested in the air skirts. We did choose them. And we're very thankful we did because of the transferability. We were able to use it in our travel trailer. So glad we didn't get the vinyl, because when we traded that in, at least we didn't have to like eat the cost of that skirt. Let's talk about how we haven't been able to just let the air skirts be, how we've had to touch them almost every day that we've had them.
Yeah.
So in the beginning with the travel trailer, we were having to inflate them every day because mm-hmm. they continued to deflate. We didn't know why at the time. And we were also having to deflate every time we wanted to pull the valves on our tanks.
Yeah, to do a flush.
And then obviously we'd have to reinflate the tubes when we were done.
And to be honest, we didn't know any different, because this obviously, we're new to RVing, we're new to air skirts, and there's not a lot of information out there on air skirts. So we just thought this is the way it was. We just assumed that winter sucks.
Yep.
It's brutal, and you just have to always be out dealing with crap. I mean, we were also dealing with frozen water lines, frozen hoses. We were dealing with other things. We're like, this is just what winter RVing is. And it was miserable. And yeah, we were going out almost every day to reinflate a lot of our tubes, and it was just driving us insane.
Yeah, and this is when it was January, so it was yeah. getting down to the single digits at night. Mm-hmm. And by the time they were flat in the evening, it was well below freezing, so mm-hmm. it was really cold, really annoying. And then we transferred it to the fifth wheel, and we were still inflating all the time.
All the time.
And finally, we decided to just go ahead and blow them to their max and use some soap and water and see if there were holes in them. See if that's what was causing this problem.
Yeah. I mean, right before I did that, I did eventually reach out to the company owner, Jim, who's really great. And because I didn't think that this was normal. And I talked to one of our neighbors who had air skirts, and he was not dealing with this. He was not inflating. He said he had one that he was maybe inflating every now and then, but he was having no issues. So I reached out to Jim, and Jim was immediately like, oh yeah, something's wrong. This is not normal for you right. to be having this many tubes go this flat this quickly. Let's try to figure out what's going on. And yes, he recommended that we inflate them and use soapy water mm-hmm. to then try to find some holes to see if that was the culprit to our problems.
And, you know, we did go with the extra large kit with the high clearance, because that's what made sense for both our travel trailer and this fifth wheel.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, we received 6 8-foot tubes and 6 4-foot tubes. Of that, all 6 8-foot tubes had 1 to 2 holes in them that we could find. And then one of the 4-foot tubes had 3 holes.
Yeah. And, you know, it's a thing to say. I know they're a great small company, so I hate mm-hmm. to, like, admit this out there, but that's what we were dealing with. And we're not sure what happened. We don't know if it was an error in shipping. However, once we relayed this information to Airskirts, within a week, we had replacement tubes.
Yes. And, you know, it could have also been human error.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't blow them up to their max capacity. At least I don't think we did.
Yeah.
And perhaps we blew them up to full and there was a pinhole leak in it because of, like, too much inflation. So that is a thing. You just have to... There's a fine balance.
There is. And it's tough to know. I mean, it was 7 tubes, so it's a really, you know, it's kind of a lot to really know if we had that much human error. We really, you know, the benefit of air skirts is they are so easy to install, and there's not this crazy method. You literally just lay them out and mm-hmm. inflate them and kind of work them into place. So either way, once we got the new tubes, everything has really kind of changed.
It has. we're figuring out the balance.
Yes.
So the thing about the tubes that you need to know if you're going to purchase the air skirts is they're going to change based on the temperature outside.
Yeah.
So we blew up one of our skirts when it was really warm. And so when the temperature dropped at night and it was really windy, we actually had a skirt blow into the street. So we are dealing with the same thing that we didn't want to deal with in vinyl.
Yeah.
But I do think that now that we've kind of figured out how much we're supposed to inflate without the possibility of puncturing them,
mm-hmm.
we shouldn't have to deal with that.
Yeah. And it's kind of comes back to also another thing that kind of led to one of those kind of deflating and blowing out is we had it in a weird spot, and it was because when we received the replacement tubes, it was freezing cold. And so we really just try to set them up as fast as possible. And so that's one thing you want to make sure you also take some time, that initial time installing them, to just kind of place them accordingly, because that does matter. And so now we think we're good. It's squared away now. We have the right size tube in the right place, and it's inflated to the right pressure. So we think we're in a pretty good spot.
Yeah, we're hoping we won't have to touch them again until we leave.
Yeah.
So that's the hope. We do have some gaps.
Right.
That I wanted to make sure that I brought up. Mm-hmm. Because when I look over at other setups with the skirts, I get a little envy because I realize that there's no wind going through their vinyl skirts. There's no wind going through their styrofoam. But we still have gaps.
We do.
They sell the stair pillows and these other smaller pieces to try and fill some of the gaps.
Mm-hmm.
They're about $60 a piece.
Yeah.
But they do sell them if we need to fill those gaps. But again, we still just don't know that even is worth it.
Yeah, we were talking about earlier. We're not sure the balance of having some gaps and how big the gaps are and if that makes enough of a difference to really cause any sort of issues underneath the RV when the temperatures get cold enough. Overall, the gaps, and we'll show some pictures of this, like, they're not major, but mm-hmm. they are significant. And, you know, the benefit, I guess, that we think is with a styrofoam or with the vinyl, you have complete coverage. Okay, so you're not going to have really any gaps with one of those systems. However, it's a very thin system, so it's not very necessarily insulating. Mm-hmm. Air skirts are huge. They're massive. I mean, even though we have these gaps, we feel that we have very good insulation mm-hmm. under the RV, and we can honestly feel the insulation through our floors.
Yes, our floors are much warmer, and we haven't had a full month utility bill since we've installed them, so we don't know if our bill is lower, but I feel like our heat is running less.
We're using less propane, absolutely. I mean, when we didn't have the skirts, when they were deflating constantly and it was getting into the single digits, we were going through a 30-pound propane tank almost every couple days. I mean, it was crazy. And so now that we have them installed, temperatures are somewhat similar. We're getting a week, you know, out of that propane. So it's really great.
So there is a difference.
Yeah.
There's gaps, but maybe it doesn't matter because we're seeing the results that we wanted in the first place while we got the skirt.
Absolutely. And I guess one other thing that I do like about the air skirts is, honestly, they look cool. They look good. You know, it's a little thing. It's trivial, but if you look at some of the styrofoam options, even some of the vinyl options, they look like garbage. And honestly, a lot of RV parks don't even allow that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to kind of weigh that as well.
Yeah. I also really like how well they fold up and the easy storage and transportation of them. So they come with these massive transportation bags, and as long as you fold the tubes in half and then roll them, they fit great in the bags, and they're just going to be so easy to move around.
They are. So I guess overall, if we were going to kind of break down, would we do it again? There's a lot of things to consider. You have to kind of consider the type of RVer you are, you know, and what you're trying to do. Like the winter, are you going somewhere to winter RV for 6 months?
Mm-hmm.
Or are you just going to go for a 2-week stint?
Right. Because if you're going for a 2-week stint, you're not doing styrofoam.
No.
Vinyl's an option.
Vinyl's an option.
But airbags are also a really good option.
Yeah. And so that's the tough balance. And we go back and forth on if we would do it again, honestly.
Yeah.
It's really tough.
it's tough, but we're glad we did.
Yes.
Just because of our very specific situation where we only owned our other trailer for less than a month. Mm-hmm. And we were able to use the exact same skirt system for this one. So in that way, we definitely made, hands down, the best decision because it was transferable.
Yeah. And I would probably do it again as well, just because I think the price, even though it's very expensive, it's worth it because it's going to hold its value.
So if we ever decide to get out of winter RVing for whatever reason, we should be able to recoup at least some of our costs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess, you know, another thing that I guess we really want to express to people that are looking to get an air skirt is just to do your research and to really think about the type of RVer you are and what you're trying to do. If you're going to be going somewhere for a month at a time, you really have to weigh the cost of air skirts. They do have sales that go on quite a bit. I know we talked about getting a veteran discount. Mm-hmm. However, they had a better sale going on than a veteran discount was offered. So just look into stuff like that. They do come on sale. They have sales often, so you can get a deal. And if you're going to be going RVing for a winter, for just a month, for 2 weeks, they're really an awesome option. And we'll let you guys know, like, what they're like in the summer, because apparently they're really great for keeping the RV cooler in the summer as well.
Keeping it cooler and keeping the draft out when you're trying to sit by the fire. So we'll keep you posted on that.
So guys, comment, let us know, like the video, and please subscribe.
And we'll be posting more videos like this about our experience in the RV.
See you guys later.